Hello friends, welcome to our RV YouTube channel. In today's session 22 of electric drives and control, we are going to discuss about type C chopper fed separately excited DC motor drive, in which we can have two quadrants of operation, that is forward motoring and regenerative braking control. So first let us discuss what are the contents of this session. So first we will have introduction about the type C chopper, and we will discuss in detail about the circuit diagram of this type C chopper fed DC motor drive, and we will discuss the operation of this type C chopper fed DC drive along with the waveform and the quadrants of operation. Next we will have the mathematical analysis in which we used to derive the speed torque relationship of the DC motor drive, and from that speed torque relationship we will study how the speed control of this DC motor drive is done, and from that base we will have the speed torque characteristics, or otherwise we used to draw the speed torque characteristics. So these are the contents of today's session. So before going to the introduction, I want to tell some assumptions and considerations which we are going to have. So there are two assumptions which we are going to consider here. The first consideration is about voltage polarity. So in our circuit diagram, please refer here circuit diagram. In our circuit diagram, the DC input voltage is given. So here the positive terminal of the terminal voltage of the supply. Okay, positive terminal of the supply voltage. That is known as plus Vs. So whenever the positive terminal of the supply voltage is connected to A and the negative terminal of the supply voltage is connected to AA, it is considered as positive armature voltage. Okay, at the output side here. In the circuit diagram, at the output side, it is considered to be positive armature voltage. But in reverse case, that means if at all the negative supply voltage is connected to A and the positive supply voltage terminal is connected to AA, means it is considered to be minus VA. But however, this second consideration is not applicable for the type C chopper. Here in this type C chopper, the first condition, this condition alone is applicable. That means we are going to have only positive output voltage across our armature terminals. Next, the consideration is about the current direction. Whenever the current flows from source to the load, it is considered as positive armature current. If at all the current flows from load to the source, that is considered to be the negative armature current. Let me show in the circuit diagram. See, whenever the current flows from the supply voltage Vs to the motor, that is considered to be the positive armature current. If at all the current flows from load, that means from this motor side to the source side, that means to the supply side, that is said to be negative armature current. Okay, so based on these considerations, let us move on to the today's session. So first let me introduce about the type C chopper. Type C chopper offers two quadrants of operation, that is first and second quadrant. The first quadrant is of forward motoring and the second quadrant is of forward regenerative braking. So these two quadrants can be obtained by means of using a type C chopper. And this type C chopper is the connection of type A and type B chopper in parallel. See, please look at the circuit diagram. So here, this in the circuit diagram, this switch S1, okay, switch S1 and diode D1 forms the type A chopper, whereas switch S2 and diode D2 forms the type B chopper. Here switch S1 and S2 may be an IGBT MOSFET or even a mass control thyristor. So we can have or we can select any of those switches for this chopper configuration. And here this type A and type B chopper are connected in parallel, which is said to be type C chopper. And this type C chopper is also known as two quadrant type A chopper. Now let us move on to the operation of the circuit diagram. Okay, and before that let us discuss in detail about the circuit diagram. Here this is a chopper. The function of a chopper is to convert fixed DC input voltage to the variable DC output voltage. So that means here fixed DC input voltage with a magnitude of Vs is applied to the circuit. So in the waveform here, which is marked in the green color, is the DC input voltage, okay, with the magnitude of Vs. And here this, as I already mentioned, switch S1 and S2 may be an IGBT MOSFET or MCT. And here this S1 and D1 forms the type A chopper and S2 and diode D2 forms the type B chopper. And here this RA represents the armature resistance of the motor and LA represents the armature inductance of the motor. And here A is the A and AA are the armature terminals of the motor. Here this E represents the back EMF of the motor. And here this VA represents the output voltage of the chopper. And here this VA across the armature terminals of the motor is armature voltage of the motor. The basic agenda or the main agenda of this is to control the speed of this DC motor by means of using this type C chopper. So how it can be done? Controlling the speed of a DC motor, here we are going to use the armature voltage control method. So how this armature voltage control works is, when we are able to change the VA, that means armature voltage, we can able to change the speed. Okay, whenever we are able to control the VA, that means armature voltage, we can control the speed. So in order to achieve the change in the output voltage of the chopper, we have to change the duty ratio of the chopper. Okay, so we have discussed about duty ratio in our session 21 and 20 also. Okay, so if we are able to change the duty ratio, we can be able to change the output voltage of the chopper. So when the output voltage of the chopper is changed, the armature voltage is changed. So when the armature voltage is changed, ultimately the speed of this motor is changed. So let us discuss about the operation of this particular chopper fed DC drive through this waveforms. Please refer to the waveform. In this waveform, please look into this red mark which I have marked in red. So at this time period, switch S1 is given the trigger signal. Okay, the trigger signal or the gate signal is given to the switch S1. Therefore, switch S1 starts conducting at this period of time, which is marked in the red color. So here what happens is, when the switch S1 is closed or when the switch S1 is given a trigger signal, the current starts flowing from positive terminal of the supply voltage to the switch S1 and to the motor and to the negative terminal of the supply voltage. So this is the current flow. So I have drawn this as equivalent circuit 1. Okay, I have drawn this current flow in the equivalent circuit 1. See here, the current is starting from positive terminal of the supply voltage and to the switch S1 and to the motor, and which ends at the negative terminal of the supply voltage. So when we apply KVL to this loop, we will get VA is equal to VS. That means the armature output voltage of the motor is equal to the supply voltage, input supply voltage. So let us draw this output voltage in our VA curve. Please refer to the VA curve in the waveforms. Please refer to the waveform here, VA. We are going to draw the output voltage here. So what we discussed is VA is equal to VS, right? According to our KVL, we have got VA is equal to VS. So from this point, I mean, which I have marked in the red cross, up to the period del t, okay, after the time period del t, our output voltage is equal to Vs. So this is drawn here, okay, Vs, which is equal to magnitude of Vs as like as input voltage. And what happens to the current at this time? Let us discuss about the current also. See here, the current is flowing from source to the load. Okay, see here, the current is flowing from the supply voltage input source to the load. That means, as we already discussed, whenever the current flows from source to the load, it is considered the positive armature current. See here, that is why the armature current is drawn in the positive region, in the positive zone. Okay, and now we have a doubt why this current is increasing. See here, this motor is connected to the supply voltage or the source. Therefore, what happens is, since this supply voltage is connected to the motor, the armature current will increase. Therefore, the current is increasing from this red cross point to the time period del t in the positive region, because the current is flowing from source to the load. This is about voltage and current during the switch S1 conduction. So when the current has increased here, that means at a period of time del t, the switch S1 is opened and the diode D1 gets forward biased. So what happens here? See, now the current starts flowing from the motor to the diode D1 and again to the motor. That means the current starts freewheeling through this diode D1. So I have drawn this in the equivalent circuit 2. Please refer to the equivalent circuit 2. So the current here starts flowing through the diode D1 and into the motor. So the current freewheels in this diode. So since the current is freewheeling here, the current decreases. And if we apply, since this is a short circuit, see here it is a, if you observe this circuit, it is a short circuit. So under short circuit, the output voltage VA is equal to 0. That means since it is a short circuit, the output voltage is 0. Therefore, VA is 0. So now let us draw this output voltage. That means from del T to the green mark, which I have marked here, the cross, the green cross, from del T, the period del T to here green cast, the output voltage is 0, because here in our equivalent circuit we have obtained as our output voltage as 0. Now let us discuss about the current also here. What happens to the current? So as we discussed earlier, since the current is freewheeling here, the current decreases. So the current is decreasing from here to here. See here, you will be able to see here. The current is decreasing from here to here since the current is freewheeling. And we will have a doubt here, either it is positive armature current or negative armature current. Here it is a positive armature current because the current is flowing from source side to the load side. See, compare with the previous direction. The previous direction is from source side to the load side. Here also the same direction. The direction is not changed. Therefore, the current is positive and it is decreasing. So this is what happening from this period to this period. That means whenever diode D1 is conducting. So when the current reaches zero, the switch S2 is given the gate pulse. That means switch S2 comes into the conduction. So now we are going to close this switch S2. Current will flow from motor through S2 and again to the motor. So here what happens is, at this condition or at this point of time, the mechanical load, whichever is connected to the motor, if it is of a active load, okay, if it is of an active load, what will happen is that that active load will provide the input energy to the motor. That means a mechanical input energy to the motor, and that input mechanical energy will be converted into the electrical output energy. And here this motor is trying to act as a generator. This motor or generator will accept the mechanical input energy from the mechanical load, and which it is converted into the electrical output energy. So this is, I have drawn in the circuit diagram 3. That means in the equivalent circuit diagram 3. See here, in equivalent circuit diagram 3, the current is flowing through the switch S2 and the motor. Switch S2 and the motor. So here, if you observe at this circuit, this circuit is of a short circuit. Therefore, under short circuit, the voltage will be 0. Hence, our VA is 0. Therefore, during the conduction period of S2, our output voltage is 0. So here, in output voltage, please come to the waveform of output voltage VA. So from here to here, that means the green cross, which I have marked in the green cross, from this time period to the time period T, switch S2 is conducting. See, you can be able to see here, switch S2 is conducting. So at this point of time, the output voltage is 0. Because here we have achieved our output voltage as 0. Now let us discuss about the current. Here, the current will increase because here the current is, the mechanical input energy is given to the motor, which is converted to the electrical energy, and this electrical energy is stored in the form of magnetic field energy in the armature inductance LA here. Okay, this is our inductance. So in this armature inductance, the magnetic field energy will store, which increases the current. Therefore, current increases. Now we have to discuss the direction of the current, either it is positive or negative. Here it is negative because if you compare with the previous circuits, the current direction is reversed. Now here the current is flowing from load to the source. That means from motor to the source. So as we already discussed, whenever the current flows from load to the source, it is considered to be negative armature current. Therefore, current is negative and the current is increasing. So here the current is negative and the current is increasing from here to here. From green point to, green cross point to the time period T, you can see here. So when switch S2 is conducting, the output voltage is 0 and the current is increasing, but it is negative. And at this time period T, the diode D2 comes into the conduction. Okay, the diode D2 comes into the conduction. So let us discuss what happens to the current flow. So the magnetic field energy, whichever is stored in the previous interval, that means when the switch S2 in the equivalent circuit 3, when the switch S2 is conducting, the magnetic field energy will be stored in the inductor. So now what happens is, when the diode D2 comes into the conduction, at that time period of time, the magnetic field energy, whichever is stored, or the current from the motor will flow through the diode D2 to the supply. So this, which I have drawn in the equivalent circuit 4, please refer to the equivalent circuit 4. So here, this armature current flows from motor terminals through the diode D2 and the supply voltage. That means here the input energy or otherwise the electrical energy is given as input to the supply side. Okay, that means we are feeding some amount of electrical energy for the supply. Therefore, the power is regenerated here. Hence, it is known as regenerative operation, or otherwise the power is reproduced here. And if we apply KVL to this loop, we will get VA is equal to VS. That means our armature output voltage at the motor terminals is equal to the supply voltage VS. So now let us draw this output voltage here. That means during the conduction of diode D2. So the diode D2 conducts from the time period T2 the cross mark which I have made here in the gray color. Okay, so from here to here, the output voltage VA is equal to VS. So which is drawn in green color as VA is equal to VS. From time period T to here, the time instant which I have marked in the gray color. So the output voltage is VS with a magnitude of VS. Okay, so now let us discuss about the current flow. What happens to the current? See here, the current direction is reversed. So therefore, it is a negative current. And either current will increase or decrease. Here, the current will decrease because the current or the input or the energy whichever is generated here is supplied to the supply side. That means the current decreases. I mean, the energy whichever is stored here in the circuit 3. That means whenever whatever the energy is stored in the circuit 3, now during the conduction of this diode D2, the entire energy is supplied to the supply side. That means to the DC input voltage side. Therefore, what happens is IA decreases. That means IA decreases and it is negative. So see here, from here to here, that means the time period T2, the mark which I have made in the gray color, the current is decreasing and it is negative. See here, it is in the negative side and the current is decreasing from this point to this point. From time period T to this gray color, the current is decreasing to zero. And again, what happens is at this period of time, the switch S1 is closed or the gate signal is given for the switch S1. The new cycle starts. From here, this cycle is repeating. Okay, this is again the new cycle. So this is how a type C chopper operates. And now let us do the mathematical analysis of this. Here, our output voltage of the chopper is given as VA is equal to 1 over the time period integration of 0 to del t VS dt. So here, this supply, the output voltage VA from, if you look at this waveform, please look at the waveform at the output voltage VA. Please look at the waveform at the output voltage VA or the armature terminals of the motor. So here what happens is from 0 to del t, the output voltage is VS, right? From 0 to del t, if you observe at this waveform, the output voltage is VS. Therefore, output voltage VA is VS from 0 to del t. Therefore, the limits are 0 to del t. And here, VA is equal to, taking VS as constant, it becomes VA is equal to VS by t. Integration of dt becomes t, because integration of dx is equal to what? X. Therefore, integration of dt becomes t and the limits are 0 to del t. So, next step is VA is equal to VS by t. If we apply the limits, we will get, applying the upper limit is del t, and when we apply the lower limit, we have to add a minus. So, here it is a minus and the lower limit is 0. Therefore, VA is equal to VS by t into del t minus 0. So, now what happens is VA is equal to VS by t, del t minus 0 is nothing but del t. So, here t and t gets cancels with each other. Therefore, we will get VA is equal to VS into del. So, that we have considered as equation 1. So, further proceeding the derivation, the equation of a DC motor is given as VA is equal to E plus IARE. So, let it be equation 2. And we know that back EMF of a DC motor is E is equal to K into omega M. Let it be the equation 3. And we know that armature current of a DC motor is equal to T by K. So, let this be equation 4. So, now let us substitute equation 1, equation 3 and equation 4 in equation 2. So, what happens is, instead of VA, we will get VS del, which is equal to K into omega M plus T by K RA. So, here I am bringing this T by K RA to the left hand side. That means a small rearrangement. Therefore, K omega M is equal to VS del minus T by K RA. And bringing this K to the right hand side, it will become omega M is equal to VS del by K minus T by, here there is a K and multiplying with K becomes K square. So, T by K square RA. So, this equation 5 is the speed torque relationship of a DC motor drive when it is fed by a DC chopper. So, if you look at this equation 5, according to this equation 5, when we change this duty ratio del, the speed changes. That means we will be able to control the speed of a DC motor. Based on this equation 5, now let us discuss about the speed torque characteristics. So, before discussing the speed torque characteristics, let us discuss about the quadrants of operation. Therefore, we can decide in which quadrants the operation of this DC motor drive when fed by a DC chopper appears. Now, let us discuss about the quadrants of operation. So, for that, please look at the waveform. So, here the red cross mark, which I have marked in the red cross mark, from up to the period del t. That means the period when the switch S1 is conducting. So at that period, what happens is the current is positive and the voltage is positive. Therefore, voltage and current is positive. So please to the quadrants of operation. Please come to the quadrants of operation. So here, output voltage is positive and current is positive, right? So which falls in the first quadrant of operation. That means when the switch S1 is conducting, at that time period, the voltage and current both are positive, which falls in the first quadrant called forward motoring. So now let us have a look on the waveform while the diode D2 is conducting. That means the diode D2 conducts from the time period T up to here, the mark which I have marked in the gray color. So please refer in the waveform, the mark which I have made in the black color, that is the time period T up to the mark which I have marked in the gray color. If you observe here, the current is negative, whereas the output voltage is positive. So it falls in the second quadrant. In the second quadrant, the voltage is positive, whereas the current is negative. So the second quadrant is known as forward regenerative braking. So this is how we are able to obtain two quadrants of operation called first quadrant of forward motoring and second quadrant of forward regenerative braking by means of using a type C chopper.
So based on the quadrants of operation discussion, it is concluded that the operation falls in the two quadrants, such as first quadrant called forward motoring and the second quadrant called forward regenerative braking. Therefore, the speed torque characteristics is drawn in the first quadrant and the second quadrant.
So here, first let us discuss about the forward motoring. So here, this is a typical speed torque characteristics. Okay, this is a typical speed torque characteristics of a DC motor. So let us assume that this curve 1 is for a duty ratio of del 1. Now for some reasons, I want to increase the speed. So what I can do is I can increase the duty ratio. Therefore, what happens is speed will increase. Therefore, speed is increased from this to this. That means from curve 1 to it is shifted to the operating curve 2. So if I want to still increase my speed, means what I can do is again I can increase my duty ratio. Therefore, the speed will be increased. So therefore, the speed is increased from curve 2 to curve 3, which is for the duty ratio del 3. So this is same applicable for this second quadrant also. So this is how we can control the speed of a DC motor by means of using a DC chopper. Thank you.